Tip number one, after you've opened a mockup, whether you've used your own mockup that you've downloaded or you're using a template, make sure that you follow the instruction from the designer of the mockup. What I mean by that is when you double click on the mockup itself and you want to open it up and you want to work on it so that you can add your logo design and then apply it so that you have a beautiful 3D mockup, follow the instruction of how the designer is showing you how to place your logo. So we usually teach to switch this off, which you should once you're done placing it. With the eye, you can switch it off and switch it on. So what do I mean by that? I mean, if you go and you fetch your own design and it looks like this, it usually picks the size that you've downloaded from Canva or remove.bg. Normally, some of the mockups, they want you to increase the size of your 2D transparent design and make it large. When you do that and you don't follow the instruction from the designer of the mockup, it ends up looking like this. Let me show you how it looks like. It looks out of place and it looks huge and it's over the line. What you should do, or the correct way to do it, after opening the mockup the normal way, you load your 2D design and then it looks like this. So it gives you a guidance of how you should, or where you should place your design in order for it to be exactly the way that the designer has intended it. So we're going to even make it a little bit smaller so that it is exact same size of what the designer has showed us. Once you've placed it, you then switch off the example from the designer. Then you convert it to a smart object by pressing Command S or Control S, or you go File and you save it as a smart object. And once it's saved, you're gonna go to your 3D mockup and you go find your design. And it's beautifully aligned exactly where it's supposed to be. All about the image that you can find on the 3D mockups that gets created. You don't have to accept the image that's loaded by the graphic designer who's designed the mockup for us. You can always replace it. When you open up the mockup itself, when you open the drop down arrow for effects, there's a background JPEG that's added by the designer. And when you double click on that JPEG image, you can then replace the image with the image that you want. You don't have to accept the image that's loaded already on the mockup. If you want to know the steps, go watch this video to teach you the steps of how to replace the image to an image that you want. The next tip covers the 3D logo mockups that are landscape. You know, the ones that have an icon, letters on the side, and the icon is big and the letters sometimes are also big. Let me show you how you handle those, because I think you might be doing it wrong. The trick with loading this mockup starts with where you download your design. So don't download as a singular design. Split your design into two. For example, the icon on its own, as well as the words on their own. And then when you jump in on Photopea and you've opened up your mockup, then go find the two downloads that you've made. So for example, we will load the first design and we're gonna size it, and then find the second download for the text, size that, and then we're going to hide the example, and then we're gonna Command S or Control S to change the design to a smart object. Once it's updated, then you go find your design and it looks stunning. Last tip, and probably not a popular opinion in this channel that loves 3D logos. A lot of focus is placed on 3D logos. Sometimes simplicity is what is needed to showcase to your client your design. Even though this is a beautiful 3D design, you could always showcase your work with an image that's beautiful at the background and show the client different kinds of colors that he would see their logo. Sometimes it's all about what the logo could look like on their company's website or their advertising or their social media platform. Let me know in the comments below which was your favorite tip out of these, or which one you're already using as we speak. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have, please smash the like button. Please subscribe to the channel. Thank you so much for spending time with me. I will see you on the next video.